We're gonna do straighten the valves out a little bit because for the springs, because if not you won't get them off.
Joe at VW Paradise, and we're working on a AWP head, and pretty much right now he pretty much banged in the
bend valves,
the bend valve back into the head, and pretty much we're gonna, I guess, try to pull the valves out, right?
Yep, we're popping the keepers off. Well, right now you got the retainer in there, uh-huh. And the valve keepers. Here's the valve keepers. Then your spring, your retainer. Basically, this is what keeps on the valve to keep them from popping off.
Gotcha.
Then you got this here. Then if you know here, you have the grooves on it. So basically, when they're on the spring and all that. The keepers go right in the grooves.
And that just keeps it from coming
popping
out.
Off. Yeah, that's what holds the valve awesome. In place and all that. And a lot of times, once in a while, you'll see some wear in the keeper groove right here. Mm-hmm. And if you do see wear in it, you need to replace the valve. Rarely these wear out, but we've seen them before.
Yeah.
And I will go ahead and keep knocking them all out. And the ones that are harder to look, you see how that one there's harder because that's the bent one.
Gotcha.
See how there it is right there.
That's a really bent valve. Holy snikes.
Right, we'll go ahead and pop the rest of them all out. And no, it's, you know, we try to make sure we get them all out. There's two right there. Because sometimes they fall down in there, and if you don't see them, they'll fall out in the hot tank. But usually we'll find them and stuff.
Plus, keepers?
Yeah. Because you know, they're small and all that, they'll fall down in if you don't grab them with a magnet. Mm-hmm. So you knock them all out, you don't remember how many you've already got. And that's why I like to do one at a time. That way I know I got them. If I don't have it, then I'll look for it.
Good information.
This one here, these bent ones, if we didn't pound them back in, mm-hmm. There's no way you can pound them, you know, pound the keepers out. Got because the spring is compressed. So what you're doing is moving it back up so it releases the spring.
The tension on the spring, gotcha.
Yeah.
Those springs are really, really high tension.
Oh, yeah. These here are pretty good tension on them. The stock ones are pretty good. Because all the two on the turbos and all, you know, you don't need them to float the valves and all that. But like if you go bigger cam, depending how big of a cam you go, you want to put bigger or a little bit tougher spring because a big cam will cause them to float, and also you can go get coil bind, and you don't want to get coil bind, and that's when you start breaking things.
I don't want to break them. Now for all the money I already spent.
Thank you.
Yeah, this guy bent the valves like crazy.
Yeah, let me grab the other one.
What do I can make out of it?
Now we gotta get the exhaust ones. They're gonna be just as bad.
Probably be worse, huh?
They'll be just as bad.
What I get? Get a free motor. Oh, I'm okay. I'm gonna be dirty when I get home. I got another engine to pull. So I'm getting ready to put this in my other car. So I'm just gonna be dirty all day. Thank you, though. I got your name, sir.
Justin.
I'm Al.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, thank you. I'm excited. I've never seen actually a shop do the work.
But this is the easiest way to get them off. You know, you could use the spring compressor with that one thing, but it's just so much more of a headache since we're replacing these valves anyway, right?
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, so it really doesn't matter.
Yeah, I got all new valves coming. And like you suggested, to do nothing larger, went back to stock size.
Valves and all, yeah.
Yeah, 100% stock.
That's better, you know, unless, like say, once you start doing all the stuff, then you need to make sure you get everything, springs and stuff and, you know, big cams and all that, then you have to do a little bit more. Sometimes they'll be stubborn.
Snapped, huh?
Yeah, it just broke a little. Well, see, that would have happened in your car if you'd have wouldn't have stopped it. Grab me the seal puller.
I got it for you.
We'll go ahead and throw all this in here out of the way. Got a special tool pulling the seals out.
And these are the
valve stem seals.
Okay. That's what prevents oil from going into
the... Yeah. From the guide and down to the... And, yeah. If you didn't have these in, it would burn oil all the time and it'd be smoking real bad. A lot of times when these seals get bad, usually on startup, it'll puff out smoke. Most of the time it tells you your seals are worn. Because oil gets through here, goes down, sits in the cylinder. When you fire it up, it blows it out.
Yep.
And once it blows it out, then it's fine.
So those all have to be replaced?
Yeah.
I hear a speed demon at this.
Oh, we do quite a few of some.
Apart fast, doesn't go back together as fast.
It's easier apart than going together. These
it's
little.
It's always easier to take something apart than it is to put it back together.
Well, you'll see when we put it back together.
Yeah.
Getting the springs and all that stuff. With
the it's getting the springs. It's getting the on these here. Getting the on these four here. The setup is a little bit off than these other ones. But they're so little. I mean, getting the. The keepers in it, yeah, it's harder to see.
Pretty much putting a keeper in blind. You gotta just know how far down to go.
Yeah. That's crazy. How long have you been doing this for?
I'm back on my second tour.
Second tour?
Yeah, so probably in the next month, all together, the year, probably about 6 years.
Here? Oh, cool. Yeah. Did you end up moving out of state or something? Or?
No, I just was at a different job that I was doing good at.
Gotcha.
Be careful you don't hit yourself pulling
out.
Oh
man, I was actually working on my bus and I was breaking loose the caliper bolt. And stupid me trying to find it where it was, and I was pulling, and then I'm like, you know what? I'm going to yank on it. I literally punched myself in the eye. I'm just like, oh, I gave myself like a little tiny black eye. My wife was like, what happened? I beat myself up. Like, why? Caliper one, I guess.
Right? Yeah. They never lose, huh?
I was just like, man, all the years of me working on, like, just doing basic stuff on cars, I've never punched myself until then.
That's the first time I've heard of that. I come close to this one because it comes close to my face.
Yeah.
You learn to lean over just a little bit.
Well, it's how I was like this, but my hand, when the breaker bar was going, it's because it was a deep socket and it fell off the nut. So I was breaking it and I felt it go click, click, you know, like the it breaking loose because it's so rusty. It was the original caliper. And so I hear it go, and then I knew where it just popped off the socket and just boom, right in the freaking eye. Worst mistake ever.
I'm gonna pull the plugs out. We don't need those in there.
Nope, don't need spark plugs.
Okay, now what we're gonna do is go over here, kind of solving it up a little bit.
We're gonna what?
Go over here and solving it up, put it in the hot tank.
So we're gonna cover the solvent?
Yeah, we're gonna clean it up a little bit. That way it's not too dirty in the hot tank. That way it doesn't dirty up the hot tank. Even though it's like this, we'll get most of the grease off. But once it goes in the hot tank, it'll do a lot better job. You break up the big stuff. I'm gonna get this out of the way. Where the timing belt goes.
That stuff cleans that stuff up really well, huh?
Oh yeah. Well yeah, this breaks it up pretty good and, you know, loosens it up and.
Oh, it comes out hot.
Yeah, it's warm.
That's why. Hot chemicals always cleans up quicker.
Okay, now. We'll go over here and put it in the hot tank.
Now we can put this bad boy in a hot tank. And what temperature does this heat up to?
This stays right around 200.
How much?
About 200.
With 200 degrees Fahrenheit?
Yeah.
And it pretty much just will literally just steam clean the crud out of the motor. With chemicals.
Turn it on for like 20 minutes and
pretty much the same process.
Yeah, it's hot, yeah, degreasing a little bit, and it's going to go into the hot tank to be cleaned up.
So they use solvent that comes out pretty warm, helps break down
the
really thick sludge and whatnot that's on the exterior of the casing.
Pretty much, once we get the block back, do you suggest to have it powder coated or anything like that?
Well, or just paint it? That's up to you.
Okay.
I keep painting them black, or, you know, we usually paint them black.
Okay.
But if you want to powder coat it, that's up to you. It's not going to, it won't over, a lot of people think it's going to overheat it. They won't overheat.
Okay.
Because even though the powder coat is on there, it's thick and all, but it doesn't. It's not going to really matter.
And then all that solvent gets recycled and gets reused,
yeah.
Right? Yeah, that's what those, I remember when I was in school, it recycles, it just filters all the grime and just pushes,
yeah.
Processes it all back through. So it's not as wasteful.
No. Well, it's illegal now to dump a lot of this stuff.
Yeah.
This isn't really a hazardous place from here, but we have a company that comes in and takes care of it.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is a solution here. It's not really like a solvent, it's like a detergent and then hot water.
Gotcha. Done from the What's good?